There are fundamental particles called neutrinos, which along with electrons and quarks are the basic building blocks of nature. These neutrinos are very weakly interacting, so they can pass out from the core of the sun, through the dense matter in the sun, through the earth. And so we put our detectors 2 kilometers underground in a mine, Creighton Mine near Sudbury, Ontario, owned by Vale. We use these detectors in a very low radiation environment to observe 1 neutrino per hour from the sun. The neutrinos are carrying information about the nuclear reactions that power the sun, and also it gives us an opportunity to determine basic properties of the neutrinos themselves. In particular, when we started our measurements, it was not known if they had a finite mass. We had a very big Eureka moment in our experiment. We purposely put in a blindness factor. We added in something extra that only a couple of people in the collaboration knew how to remove, and performed our analysis with that in place. And then on one day, we decided we had defined exactly what the analysis was supposed to do, and we turned off the blindness. And there it was. It was a real Eureka moment. Queen's has, along with the others, played an important role in the success of this project. The generations continue in which we're able to give students the opportunity to feel that they can do science at the cutting edge, as we did with SNOW and as we will do with SNOW Lab in the future. We have, as scientists, so much respect for the committee of the Royal Academy in Sweden that makes these choices and has made them for years. This honor is really, in terms of a scientific honor, really at the top of the scale.